first we would say we work on interfaces, and interfaces are always tools, visual or mechanical tools, to connect between people and machines. In 1989, the Berlin Wall was falling. We did work on an interactive table.
The philosopher Hannah Arendt mentioned the table as an object is on the one side, it's like a cornerstone. It gives a sort of distance between, but also creates an atmosphere of communication. You wouldn't sit around on a table with another person you don't know without saying a word. So something starts.
With this interactive table, we showed parts of the history, what was under the death stripe.
The bunkers of the Hitler bunkers were found and were immediately closed again, so that it not becomes a place where neo-Nazis come to meet. But we wanted to show.
And we wanted to invite four different philosophers or thinkers to bring them together in a kind of conference, but like in a theater play, in a building, where they should talk about their ideas of the future.
The layout of the new National Gallery in Berlin, the abstract and symbolic use of colors and shapes deliberately creates a distance to the real world.
When we did Home of the Brain or Cyber City, and Home of the Brain was even more difficult because it was the first kind of virtual reality work with a data glove and head-mounted display.
So it is like building an own storyline when walking through this space.
For example, with Liquid Views, it was for me it was really sensational that I saw at that time, you know, a virtual well. It was not usual that you could touch something. There was no touch screen at that time.
Here in November in 2004, visitors unexpectedly find themselves in an interactive language game. The real-time installation transforms the daily newspaper into a walk-in data stream of words and artificial voice. A touchscreen displays the daily news in 500 keywords from which visitors can select. The installation has recorded over 4 weeks what visitors choose and how they follow their own interests with these words. Do we want to understand the digital world or the world we live in? That's always the question in all of our works. In 4 weeks with energy passages in public space, we had 4,000 visitors. They came alone with the family, and the next time they brought friends to discover, learn, and discuss together. Many have expressed their thanks for seeing what is currently being developed in research institutions and made understandable through artistic installations. They felt involved and invited to think about the future.
Yeah.